Hello everyone. In this video, I will tell you about Posselt's envelop. Dr. Posselt in 1952 described the three-dimensional movement of mandible. These three-dimensional movements were called the border movements, and these are described in three planes: sagittal, frontal, and horizontal. The border movements are limited superiorly by teeth contact, and rest of the borders are determined by temporomandibular joint and ligaments. A few postural positions that you must know are centric relation, maximum intercuspation, and rest position. So what is centric relation? It is the maxillomandibular relationship where condyles articulate with the thinnest avascular portion of the discs, with the entire complex in the anterosuperior position, lying against the slope of the articular eminence. Centric relation is independent of tooth contact, and this position is determined by the condyles. Centric relation is repeatable, reproducible, and recordable. Now, what is maximum intercuspation position? At this position, there is complete intercuspation of the opposing teeth. Maximum intercuspation is independent of condylar position. It is teeth determined. And in most people, it does not coincide with the centric relation, though it may coincide in 10% of the population. Now, what is rest position? This is the usual position of mandible when the patient is resting comfortably in upright position. In such a position, the condyles are in neutral, unstrained position in the glenoid fossa. So, in this position, there is approximately 2 to 3 millimeters of space between maxillary and mandibular teeth in the incisor canine region. Now, let's go to the movements that are shown by the mandible. So, the mandible is capable of showing two types of movement. One is rotation and the other one is translation. Rotation is seen in the lower joint cavity of the TMJ, and it is somewhere around 20 to 25 millimeters, whereas translation is seen in the upper joint cavity and it is around 25 to 35 millimeters. So in total, maximum opening of mandible is around 50 to 60 millimeters. The maximum left and right lateral movement of mandible is 10 to 12 millimeters. Maximum protrusion is about 8 to 10 millimeters, and maximum retrusion is around 1 millimeter. Let's now go to the mandibular movement in the sagittal plane. So the geometrical shape that you see on your right is the envelope of motion of mandible in the sagittal plane, and it is beak shaped. It represents the movement of mandible in the sagittal plane. So the highest point is the maximum intercuspation, or the centric occlusion position. From here, when you retrude the mandible goes from centric occlusion into the centric relation position, which is the posterior most point on the superior border. Now, when you open the mandible, the first movement is rotational, which is about 20 to 25 millimeters and is represented by R on the diagram. From here, when you further open your jaw, the movement is translational, which is about 25 to 35 millimeters. So, the total mandibular depression or the total mandibular opening would be 50 to 60 millimeters. From here, close your jaw in such a way that it is in the most protruded position. So, this position is represented by P on the envelope, and this would be the maximum protrusion. Now, when you retrude the mandible, it first goes into the edge-to-edge contact. In this position, the incisal edges of maxillary incisors and mandibular incisors are in contact. And this position would be lower as compared to all the other positions on the superior border. That is, it would be lower than the centric occlusion, centric relation, and maximum protrusion. Upon further retrusion, mandible goes back into the centric occlusion. And upon relaxation, the mandible depresses slightly so that it goes into the rest position. Let's now see the mandibular movement in frontal plane. The envelope of motion of mandible in frontal plane resembles a shield, and the highest point is centric occlusion or maximum intercuspation. While maintaining the occlusal contact, slide the mandible towards left, and this is the maximum left lateral position. From here, when you depress the mandible, that is when you open the mandible, you will notice that the mandible, while opening, comes into the center. Now from here, close or elevate mandible to the maximum right lateral position, and then again slide back into the maximum intercuspation. So this is the border movement of mandible in the frontal plane. And upon relaxation, the mandible again depresses slightly so that it goes into the rest position. Let's now see the mandibular movement in horizontal plane. The envelope of motion of mandible in horizontal plane is diamond shaped. In this diagram, O represents the maximum intercuspation. From here, first retrude the mandible so that the mandible goes into the centric relation. And please note here that the centric relation in this diagram appears to be the lowest point. But this is only so that you can easily correlate it with the motion of mandible that you can see on your left. But you should always remember that the centric relation is the highest point on the horizontal envelope of motion, and protrusion is the lowest point. So just flip this diagram so that the centric relation is on top and protrusion is on bottom. Now once the mandible is in centric relation, next move your jaw to the extreme left. You will notice that while the mandible moves laterally, it also moves slightly anteriorly. Now protrude the mandible and you will realize that mandible has come into the center. From here, again slide the mandible to the maximum right lateral position, and while doing so, the mandible moves backward and laterally. Now slide the mandible back to centric relation and you will realize that the mandible retrudes and also moves medially. Now protrude the mandible slightly so it goes back into the maximum intercuspation position. And from here, if you still protrude slightly, the mandible is in edge-to-edge contact with the maxillary anteriors. And this is represented by E on the diagram. So these were the three Posselt's envelope in the sagittal, frontal, and the horizontal plane. I hope I was able to make it easy for you. So if you like the video, please like, comment, and share the video. And please don't forget to subscribe. Thank you.